Welcome back. In this video, I want to take a look at a problem that is becoming more common as these recorders reach almost 20 years old now. I picked up another BR1600 over the weekend, and apart from being a bit dusty and looking like it hasn't been used for a while, it's in pretty good shape. Unfortunately, when it boots up, I get the dreaded hard drive error message. Apart from a dead or dying hard drive, there are two other reasons that can give you this error. The first is if you have a CD in the optical drive when you start it up. Sometimes the BR1600 will try and boot from the CD instead of the hard drive, and you get this message. There was a CD in the drive, but removing it and rebooting still gives the error. The second is using a faulty or incorrect power supply. I've seen this error show up if you use a non-original power supply or one that doesn't supply the correct voltage. Although this power supply is original, it does look like it's been repaired, so to eliminate it as an issue, I'll try another power supply. We still see the error, so it does look like the hard drive is the problem. Let's look at how we go about replacing it. Lay something down on a flat surface to protect the front of the machine, as we need to turn it over to remove the bottom plate and get access to the hard drive. There are 18 screws that need to be removed, of which there are 3 different types. 9 are for fixing into the metal frame. 6 with a coarse thread are fixing into plastic, and 3 which hold the optical drive in place. Lift off the bottom plate and put it aside. The hard drive is held in place with 4 rubber isolation mounts fixed into the sides of the drive. The drive itself is held in place with a bracket fixed into the frame with 2 screws. First, we can remove the IDE and power cables. You can also remove these after you've unscrewed the drive, which can help if the cables are stubborn and hard to pull out. Undo the 2 screws. Push the bracket outwards and pull it up while you support the drive. You can now take the hard drive out of the frame. Each of the isolation mounts is fixed with a screw. Remove all 4 from the old drive. With the old drive removed, let's see what the official word is from Roland on replacing a hard drive. Firstly, the operating system resides on flash ROM inside the unit, so there is no need to reload the operating system when replacing the drive. For compatibility, the replacement should be a 3.5-inch IDE drive. When the BR16 was originally released, it came with a 40 gig 5400 RPM drive. Later, when it was upgraded to 80 gig, they were shipped with a 7200 RPM drive. Any standard IDE drive, regardless of speed, will work. You do not need to format or partition the drive before you install it. 80 gig is the maximum size that will be recognized by the BR1600. Larger drives can be used, but any space above 80 gig will be ignored. Add the isolation mounts back onto the new drive. Push the drive into the frame and replace the bracket. Fix in place with the 2 screws. Plug the IDE and power cables back into the new drive and refit the bottom plate. If you want to test the drive before replacing the plate, be aware that the CD drive is loose when the base plate is removed, so you'll need to hold it in place if you turn the BR16 over, otherwise it could fall out. On booting for the first time, it will either ask you to format the drive or still show a hard drive error. This is completely normal. Press the Enter key to continue to the main screen. The drive needs to be formatted inside the BR1600 before it will work properly. Go into Utility, Hard Drive, and Initialize. Press Go to format the drive. This should only take a couple of minutes. The maximum size of a partition on the BR1600 is 40 gig. Restart the machine to check that everything now works as it should. Go to Utility, Hard Drive and Info to see details on the newly created partitions. We can see that even though I've used a 120 gig drive, only 40 gig is available. To be able to use a drive that is larger than 40 gig, the firmware needs to be updated to version 2.01 or higher. To check what firmware version is installed on the BR1600, press the left and right arrow buttons while on the home screen. If you don't have version 2.20, which was the last one released, then you should do an update. You can download it from the Roland website, and I'll leave a link in the description to the file and instructions. You need to extract the firmware from the zip file that you download and then burn it to a CD. This can be a single-use CD or a rewritable. The file has to be placed in the root directory of the CD, that is, it shouldn't be placed inside a folder. The CD must be formatted as an ISO 9660 Level 2 Mode 1 disk. Once you have the CD burned, hold the stop and play button and power up the BR1600. Insert the CD and follow the on-screen instructions. The upgrade should only take a minute or two. Power off the machine and then restart. Now that it's been updated, we can reformat the drive to take advantage of the extra space. Now we have two 40 gig partitions available, which is the maximum you can have on the BR1600. I hope you found the video helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.